welcome guys, I'm back in GTA 5, and in today's episode I'm gonna be showing you how to build an awesome drifting car in GTA 5. With that, and there's one that you can buy from the website, car website, so I'm gonna buy it. So let me just go to the website, and it's Legendary Motorsport, and the car is the JV700. I don't care what color it is, let me just Okay, now let's go to the garage and get the new JB700. Oh yeah, JB700. And one more thing, please subscribe to my channel if you enjoy the content, and subscribe and like to my videos. Subscribe to my channel, I will bring more videos like this. Anyway, and one more thing I want to uncover in this video is the people who have Xbox 360 or PS3. And if you play GTA Online is shutting down. GTA Online is shutting down for PS3 and Xbox 360. This is the information. Anyway, let's enter the garage and see a new JB700. And JB700 is based off the Aston Martin of real life. And it is the James Bond car, if you look closely, and if you watch the James Bond movie, it is the James Bond car. Now let's go to the garage, customize it, and do some drifting. Now you need to follow my steps. First get a drift car. I will make a separate video on drift car actually. What are the drift cars and how much do it drift? JV700 is one of them. Let's go to the garage. Oh look, this car already drifts like so well. I'm not that good at this thing, and I'm not used to it, but I'm dry. You go in the garage. The Dubauchi JB700. The Dubauchi is Aston Martin and Julian. Hey, don't put the arm. So follow my steps. Put brakes. Not the engine. Put the respray, black and gray. Put the suspension, not the turbo wheels, and the wheels should be sports wheel, I think. I know these ones are good. Wheel color should be red, is okay. Okay, now follow my steps. This one is mine. The step I'm going to show you now is the main one to build a fully drift car. So you take a gun. I'm playing on another profile on the GTA series profile, the series I made. So to the center of the wheel and then shoot it. Shoot that, make sure the cops come in. So they will like go in and come and make the no rider car. The car will like the JDM car or something. Thank you. This I love it then. Yeah, let's go and drift. These were the steps. Now I'm gonna be showing you. How to drift. For that, I know a particular spot which is perfect to drift. Let me give you a hint. It's related to Tokyo Drift. Now we need to go to the spot. Look, I'm good at drifting. It will like drift really cleanly over here, the GV700. And this is 260, it will not 260, it was 100. Yeah, anyway. We need to maintain speed for drifting. I'm gonna be explaining this in another video on drift. I just don't know why it like slipped and then stopped. But there was actually a car in GDFL called Karim Sutter. It took drift a lot. And there's another car. I'm not telling you some name. And there's another car called the Drift Yosemite. Drift Yosemite in GT Online. Not and for Xbox 360 and PS3 players for till 16 December, because GT Online will be no more for them on 16 December. And that and the car that I passed, the car that you see, the black one, is the perfect car for drifting. I'm not gonna be doing that car, customize that car, because it will take a lot of time. Look, it drifts good actually. Not in public places, a awesome flat land. Should be good. Let's go. And this car was used in a particular mission in GTA 5. Watch my full GTA 5 series. You know the mission. Railway track. For gradually my car. That's not really a car actually. That was a good trick, to be honest. That was a good trick. Good one. That was actually a good one. Now I'm gonna be doing some cool drift in the yard. The Tokyo docks I'm going to. This is actually situated in Los Angeles. I told you that in the first video of my GTA 5 series. But GTA 5 is way better than Minecraft, to be honest. But that doesn't mean I discontinued Minecraft. I still got Minecraft and the series I started. Okay. I'm not that good at drifting in GTA 5, okay? But the steering, it was good. No. Yeah, this. The dockyard. It's a good spot to drift, to be honest. Look. A 360, I mean a 180. Please maintain some speed to drift. The main trick is to press the handbrake, because I got my Xbox 360 controller and you just press the handbrake button. If you have an Xbox One or anything, Xbox 360 and Xbox One controllers are the same. So for let me just drift around this pole like. For goodness sake, I'm not good at drifting that much. But I know drift. Maintain some speed. And off you go. This car, I am YouTube, I saw some people, like, they drift in GTA 5 like pros. They're like, they have a steering to drift. Oh, look, I'm drifting in a circle. Look. I love drifting in a circle, guys. I'm good at drifting, I know the trick to drift. Let's just do some more, because it was, like, so fun. The main trick is you go like this, and then you maintain your tires like this. Wait. Drifting is actually okay, but the GTA 4 drift car driving physics was like Tokyo Drift. Actually, I'm actually not kidding. But this is GTA 5, you're focusing on GTA 5. No. I almost made it. The bonnet flew off, but I don't really care because it's like this. The main trick is that actually you need to press the handbrake like twice, like this. Yeah, that's the trick actually. Look, I love drifting in circles. I like drifting, not love drifting, but I actually love drifting. But some more, I'm gonna show another figure eight thing. Whoa, look at that. One last time, but over the turns. Okay. Yes, so actually, that's it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed. I was loving to do some more drifting. But the video limits, you know. So, goodbye. See you next time.